Would you believe it if I told you that someone loves you so much that he would be willing to die for you? I wonder if we know just how much the Father God cares for every human soul who suffers and despairs, who gropes in fearful paths for some identity in this great world of need, and a little sympathy. The heart of Jesus breaks for all injustice done unto the least of these, everyone. Look up to heaven and know the one who saves from sin. When we unlock the door of love, he will come in. And I warmly welcome you to Night Sounds. The words to the music of love. Compassion by John Michael Talbot. Opening the program, Night Sounds. I've called our time together The Distorted God. Not too long ago, I was reading of some of the history of Helen Keller. Biographers tell us that at 2 years of age, Helen Keller became deaf and blind after a severe illness. This sensory impairment made her unaware of her parents' love during most of her formative years. We're told that her mother stood daily over Helen's crib, telling the child of her parents' love for her. But the mother lamented that, quote, "I cannot make you understand. Your eyes are closed, and your ears are stopped." Tonight, as we come together, after dark, through the program Night Sounds, I wonder just how many of you have a distorted image of God. Your ears are stopped, your minds and eyes of your intellect are closed. I think that God, our heavenly parent, must also grieve that so many of us have spiritual ears and eyes that are damaged by the mild or severe abuse we may have experienced as children in dysfunctional families. Now and then we'll receive a letter to Night Sounds from someone who was raised by brutal parents, especially the father. And their image of God has been distorted, especially when we say that God is a heavenly father. For one who suffered under brutality and violence, or rape, or some horrendous thing like that, it's very difficult to convince this person that God, the Heavenly Father, would be any different, because the only frame of reference this person might have is that brutality. So it comes as no surprise that our relationships with our earthly parents affect our concept of our heavenly parent. In fact, it's even possible to predict a person's image of God from the type of dysfunction in the person's family. For instance, some come from a home where cruelty seemed to be the order. So they equate this with God. This is the most extreme distortion of his true nature. And this unbiblical concept of God is the spiritual legacy of adults who repeatedly received brutal, unpredictable abuse in childhood, most often from the hands of their fathers. If you're one of the bruised believers who experienced severe physical or sexual abuse as a child, this might be the way you picture God, and you struggle to trust your Father in heaven. Another unfortunate image we have of God is one of a demanding and unforgiving authority figure. This seems to be the heavenly parent most often worshipped by Christian adult children of rigid, perfectionistic parents. No matter how much we try, we can never seem to measure up to the demands of this distorted deity who neither forgives nor forgets our failures. I think I come under this category. I'm punishment-oriented, and if God doesn't punish me, then I guess I'm disposed to punish myself. And when we fall short, watch out. That's when we feel that God's cruel side is revealed. Some even think that God seems to take particular delight in sending financial disaster or physical disease to underscore his intolerance of spiritual shortcomings. Some time ago, we recorded a program on Night Sounds with the title, "Is God Mad at You?" Then there's another image, the selective, unfair God. Isn't cruel, capricious, demanding, or unforgiven with all Christians, only those shame-bound adult children who bow before him. And all these distortions, rooted in childhood spiritual abuse by authority figures, find this false god is the epitome of a shame-shaped deity. Another image we have of our Heavenly Father is that he's distant and unavailable. He may care about worshipers, but he's off somewhere running the universe and can't be bothered with getting too involved in your life or mine. Were your parents physically or emotionally unavailable through prolonged absences? Maybe through death, divorce, illness, military duty, or even neglect? We might experience God as eternally inaccessible. And then finally, the kind but confused God. This is a bumbling, benign being, rather confused by all the chaos of the world. Maybe he had a history way back there of caring, but with the pressures of the day, he's not there the way we need him. Maybe this is your distorted deity. If you perceived your parents as overwhelmed by the uncontrollable chaos in the lives of you or the rest of your family. In Psalm 50, verse 21, in the Old Testament of the Bible, God identifies the soil in which distortions of his character grow. We think that God's just like human beings. Most specifically, we think he's just like our parents. And this is a natural phenomenon for most children. Unfortunately for Christian adult children, our darkly shadowed distortions don't automatically disappear in the light of Christian conversions. I've been wrestling with some of these things for years, trying to correct distorted concepts. The Moffat translation of Psalm 9, verse 10, suggests the key element. It reads, "Those who know what thou art can trust in thee." So we can only trust in him when we come to know him for who he really is. So maybe there are two gods in your experience. The one you equate with your parents, and that shadowy one out there who's got to be believable, credible. Would you believe that God, motivated by love, directed by divinity, surprised everyone? He became a man. In an untouchable mystery, he disguised himself as a carpenter, lived and grew up in a dusty Judean village, and determined to prove his love for his creation, he walked incognito through his own world. His calloused hands touched wounds, and his compassionate tongue touched hearts. He became one of us. What determination! What incredible love! And by his Spirit, he hasn't left us. He's here right now, waiting to touch you with compassion. If only you knew.
If only they knew his love. If only they knew his peace. If only they knew that their joy could be complete. If they'd lay
they knew.
Radio Bible Class chorus with a very meaningful song because it zeroes in on what we're dealing with tonight, a distorted God. This is Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce. And as I come by your place each time together at night, I really wait on God to direct me as to the topics chosen, the music selected, the style of delivery, and more often than not, the subjects that we get into, I've been involved with either positively or negatively somewhere. So I don't speak from some ivory tower, but I'm identifying with many of you. There's a personal, intimate, vulnerable factor to all of this, and I'm very glad for it because it's unique. I've nothing to lose by trying to be impressive or presidential or something I'm not. In fact, again, more often than not, I come into this studio, speak on this microphone with a sense of deep need and hesitancy to even come near the studio. And often I've said to the Lord, I am not your man. I am not the one who should be speaking on this microphone tonight. I've got too many hurts and too many things going on. I'm not together. And were it not for that beautiful verse that he gave St. Paul, my strength is made perfect in weakness, I'd be out of here. But Paul went on with his ministry. With a thorn in his flesh, he couldn't get rid of it, didn't respond to prayer. And many of you tonight are suffering with a thorn of a distorted image of God, and you fear him. You may acknowledge him and put on the appearance of worship, but inside, you're terrorized. I hope you stay tuned. I think we need each other, and certainly we need a God of love. If we can help you further through other aspects and facets of this ministry, please feel free to contact us. Our mailing address is Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. I saw a picture of a beautiful woman. She looked like she had it all together. She could have been a model, smiling, seemingly well-adjusted. But this woman came from a dysfunctional, shame-based family. And she shared how she had worked through many dysfunctional patterns in her own adult life. And now, she's a practicing psychotherapist and has helped many others, like herself, learn new, healthier ways to live. Her name, Sandra Wilson. And I want to quote from her tonight. She said, "If you've come from a dysfunctional family and you have a distorted concept of God, admit your anger and disappointment with Him. This won't come as any shock to God, but it might come as a shock to you that Christians can have those feelings. Adult children often struggle to separate the physical reality of this world from spiritual reality. Maybe your reason has gone something like this. If God is kind and just, then life ought to be kind and just. The flip side being, since life has been unfair and cruel to me, God must be unfair and cruel." Another suggestion she makes, which helped her, come, choose to trust God. Trusting is a choice. If your parents weren't consistently reliable, if you've been victimized, it might be difficult for you to trust Him. But you can make a new choice by consciously deciding to trust. If you're willing to practice this choice, pray to Him, tell Him, ask Him to empower you. Choose your church family. You had no choice over the family you grew up with, but you can choose now. Evaluate your current relationship with Him. One relationship where many Christians get stuck is the have-to response. I have to obey God because my relationship with Him is based on my law-keeping and good works. We are not regarded by God on the basis of our performance. He knows us. He knows our fears. He's waiting for us to trust Him. And I pray tonight that your image of God, your concept of Him, might be healthier, might come into true focus of His love. Let's listen now to these words. Here's Janice McLaughlin to sing.
There's no need to run away. You cannot hide from Him, for He sees the hurt you have inside. And when no one seems to care or even understand, He is always there. In Him you can confide. My Father knows just what you're going through. My Father, my Father knows.
O Lord our God, we thank you tonight that you do know us. We want to know you as you can be known. A God of love and compassion, of mercy and provision. A God of protection. And Lord, as we read through the history of the Jewish people, when you pronounced judgment on them for their disobedience, you always followed it with a word of compassion and restoration and love. Lord, tonight many have a distorted view of you, including myself, so I pray that you will stabilize us, neutralize these awful impressions we've grown up with. Help us to align ourselves by choice with you and allow your spirit to touch us, to soften our hearts and our perspective. Thank you for your love. We rest in it tonight. In the name of Jesus, amen. I respect you and I thank you for listening and for hearing. And if we can help you further as we are able, please don't hesitate to call on us. Our mailing address is Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. May the Lord give you a confident day tomorrow. And until we meet again, a peaceful good night.